Hello, welcome once again to Life Signatures Live. I hope you're holding yourself well. I hope everything around you is okay. And regardless of the circumstances under which you find ourselves, there's someone who sang a song and says, life goes on. Life has to keep on moving. At least sometimes you hear that comment when people are telling you, move on, as if it's an easy thing to do. And you and I will realize that for the most part, moving on, especially when circumstances and situations have changed, is not necessarily an easy thing to do. And today's episode here on Facebook Live is something that is not so easy for me to do because of the conditions that I'm finding myself in. But I have something that I've always known, that consistency is an important part and parcel of life, especially if you're building yourself up for just about anything. At times, quantity can be better than quality. I was reading an article a day before yesterday talking about this rapper who died at 25 years of age, and this article says that he had produced more than 900 songs to his name, and the quality of some of those songs that charted made sure that his name was on the charts, on the Billboard charts, was because of the quantity he was producing. So the quantity led to the quality. And so today, I know I'm not feeling so strong, and probably that's not what I should be sharing with people, but I thought that it's better to share something than not. It's better to come and tell people something than just sit back and shut out. The reason as to why I'm insisting that I have to do this today is because this message has been in my spirit for more than 4 days now, and I feel it is important for us to share one with another. And what I'm sharing is simply a message about fueling our growth and our development by the use of our aspirations. And that is absolutely important. For the audiences of those guys who normally read the Bible, I'll quote for you a scripture that talks about aspirations. And it talks about God being limited by the nature or by the quantity or the quality or the size of our aspirations. I know it doesn't say exactly that, but I can tweak it that way. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20, it says God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ask or think or imagine, according to the power that is at work within us. God is able, and his ability to do whatever it is that is in your life is commensurate to what I am able to do in terms of my thinking and in terms of my asking. In other words, God's doing in my life is kind of commensurate to my aspiration, my thinking, my believing, my imaginations. In other words, the more I imagine and the more I bring into my life those imaginations, that is what activates the aspect of God doing that thing that I've imagined. And how does it do it? It does it exceedingly and abundantly and above what I have imagined. And you might know this to be a fact. For example, there are some things in your life that you thought were impossible some years ago, and you imagined them, and you are like, if I can only get that thing moving on in my life, if only I can make that thing become part and parcel of my life, I will be thankful to God. I will be so grateful. And guess what? You went ahead and you achieved that particular thing in your life. And now it looks like it's common as table salt, as in it's not a big deal. Someone told us that miracles normally are a commonplace years or maybe even months or even days after they have happened. But let's not go away from the topic. The topic here is aspirations. The more I aspire, the more I am fueling the dream of growth and maturity in my life. And this aspiration in my life might come from different angles. goes. Some people get aspirations, especially when they're going through pain. And sometimes pain is good. And I'm not being sadistic here. I'm saying this in retrospect. When pain is existing in my life at that moment in time when I am feeling the pain, it is not fun. But I can use that pain, I can use that upheaval, I can use that uncertainty in my life to aspire. The aspiration is telling me that, hey, wait a minute, there can be a life outside of this pain. There can be a life, a better life, a comfortable life outside of this situation, this uncertainty, this uncomfort, this discomfort that I'm feeling at this moment. That is a measure of aspiration. But the bottom line at the end of the day is this: without any form of aspiration, without any level of aspiration in anyone's life, then growth becomes something that is not possible. Growth becomes something that is distant. Growth becomes something that is not even pursued at any level of life or another. So I don't know what pain it is that you're going through, in what area of your life, what sector of your life. The guy who is broke, that brokenness becomes the seed of his aspiration to gain financial independence. The guy who is lonely, that loneliness becomes the seed for his aspiration to have company and to have a relationship. The guy who is ignorant, doesn't have knowledge, that lack of knowledge becomes the seed for his aspiration to gain as much knowledge and as much information as possible. The guy who does not have this and does not have that, whatever he lacks, whatever the pain that he is going through, becomes the seed for his aspiration to pursue that which is lacking, to get rid of the pain. The pain that is available at the moment becomes the seed for the aspiration. If the pain in life at the moment is a heartache, that becomes the seed that makes you to aspire to have coziness and joy and happiness and vulnerability and fulfillment in a relationship. But at the end of the day, the bottom line is this: whenever there is no aspiration, there is not going to be any form of growth, any form of development. It just goes that way. You can take that to the bank. When you are not aspiring, what you're doing is actually thinking that you're maintaining the status quo. And the problem with that kind of thinking is that you are not necessarily maintaining the status quo. You are actually regressing. You're actually going backwards. One thing about regressing is that you will never know that you are regressing. You always think that you are on the same level that you were yesterday. You always think that things are okay, and yet you are regressing. You might not even know. But when there is a level of aspiration in your life, that aspiration makes you uncomfortable with the status quo, because you're like, I don't like what I am seeing today. I don't like what I am feeling today. I don't like what I am experiencing today. It is not something that I really love. And that gives you this discomfort that makes you to move to do something about that discomfort. That is a level of aspiration. And I want to talk about another level of aspiration from a different angle, totally different angle. Not necessarily from the pain, because pain can make you to have an aspiration, to get out of it, to experience the exact opposite of what you're experiencing. So if you look around your life and you see there is some level of pain, probably that is a hint that is telling you, wait a minute, the flip side is also a possibility. And so you start aspiring to reach out to that particular end. But there is another level of aspiration where is basically visionary, where you're not going through pain, but you are seeing something that you are reaching out to. and it is not available today. Let me just use an example of myself. I see myself, or I aspire to see myself speaking to inspire multitudes upon multitudes of people. That level of aspiration will not make me sleep 24 hours, sleep 12 hours, sleep 15 hours. That level of aspiration imputes some kind of responsibility into my life, that I start looking at myself not as I am, but what I could be. And what I could be necessitates for me to change how I appear in life today. So if I see myself, for example, as a highly paid speaker to the ilk of Les Brown, to the ilk of Zig Ziglar, then my aspiration forces me or gives me a responsibility to do something towards that aspiration, towards that vision. And I start dressing like them. I start walking like them. I start thinking like them. I start removing things from my life that do not fit that portfolio or that particular profile, because of the aspiration or the vision that I have for myself about my life, about my future. And now the urgency that I have in appearing in life, the urgency that I have in doing some things in life, is greater because of the aspiration, as compared to when there is no vision, when there is no aspiration. The Bible says that though people who do not have vision, they cast off restraint. They just walk around life doing life, not caring about the consequences of life. And at the end of the day, the potential that God put inside of them, it goes untapped. That's when Miles Monroe comes and tells us that the richest place in the world is the graveyard, because people died and went to the grave with their potential. There are some guys actually who have died and their potential was expended to the dregs of beetles. You can look at their lives and you see that they did mighty things. And those guys, you can never negate the fact that they operated in their life from the angle of aspiration, from the angle of boundless possibilities, things that can be, things that could be. And that is what is driving their lives, not the past, that things that were, things that have passed, things that have gone, are no longer things that are pushing them, but things that are ahead, things that are possibilities, things that can be better. Remember that saying, good, better, best. Do not let it rest until the good is better and the better is best. So two things in terms of aspiration. There are those aspirations that we acquire in the moments of our turmoil, in the moments of our pain. When I was employed, my very first employment, I think I've told you about this, they were looking for someone who has some knowledge in computers, actually someone who has IT knowledge. That is what they said. And I was so excited because I had a higher diploma in management information system. So I run to that particular place and I get a crowd of guys who interview me, give me a small interview. And now that interview, they tell me, yes, you are qualified, because they saw that things I can be able to do and so on and so forth. But something bizarre happened shortly after. They called an intern, a young petite lady, and they gave this intern two lab coats and a gas mask. I remember it as if it was yesterday. And she takes me to a cellar upstairs in some forgotten room, dingy, dark-lit, dusty. And my assignment was to look for some particular phrases in papers that were strewn all over the place. They were not organized. They were actually thrown into that room. It's basically their recycle bin, so to speak. And my assignment was to look for a phrase in any one of those papers. Why were they doing that? They were doing that because either they were in court, because someone had probably taken them to court, or they had taken someone to court, and they were looking for evidence in their recycle bins. And so I delve into this work, start looking for these things the whole, basically nearly the whole afternoon. And just out of the blue, it just dawned on me, what are you doing, Lawrence? What are you doing in this place? You have been in school for 20 plus years. You have a higher diploma in management information systems. Look at you. What are you doing in this place? Looking through papers in a dingy place. This is not where you belong. And all of a sudden, some pain just rose into my spirit and into my heart, and I started weeping. I mean, started weeping without a sound coming out. Started just heaving this serious weep, and it's like my life has amounted to this at this moment. And at that particular moment in time, that pain necessitated for me to start aspiring for a better life, a greater life. I knew in my spirit that I was not meant for this. You see, if you're not going to come to that level in your life where you decide that I am not meant for this, that this pain that I'm going through is not my portion, if you will continue accepting it, continue onboarding it, that is going to continue being the status quo. But if now you flip the side and say, I am not meant for this, this is not my portion, this is not my cup, I know God has assigned me my portion and my cup. God has made the boundary lines fall for me on pleasant places. And surely I have a better heritage. I have a godly heritage. And you start aspiring towards that. Saying no to mediocrity. Saying no to average a kind of life. Saying no to normalcy. Now aspiration starts opening up your path of progress and your path of success, and you start pursuing it because you have something that you're looking forward to. That is one way. So the aspiration comes from the angle of pain. I don't know what pain it is that you're looking at in your life today. All of us at one point in time, we have pain. We have pain in terms of our finances. We have pain in terms of our careers. We have pain in terms of our relationships. We have pain in terms of very many things, in terms of family. Whatever thing that we are experiencing in form of pain, can we sit down and just write an aspiration which is the exact opposite of the pain that we're experiencing? Because it is a possibility. And that aspiration becomes an object, a consummate object that consumes us, that we want to make sure that it becomes part and parcel of our lives. So you become in life someone who is urgent, someone who is focused, someone who has direction, someone who knows that there is something that they're looking for, or they're aspiring to, or they're pushing towards in their life. And it's actually coming from the angle of pain. We can change our pain and we can turn it into pleasure. And by the time that you've turned that into pleasure, you notice that there are very many other people who are going through the same pain. And now you're able to resonate with them. You're able to know what kind of pain that they're going through, because you went through that pain yourself and you got out. And now you've just anointed yourself, or you've just been anointed to become their deliverer. That is how life operates. Anytime you're going through pain, chances are that you are a deliverer in that particular aspect of life. A deliverer for yourself, your family, and maybe other people. You're broke today. You could be someone else's deliverer tomorrow. You're having turmoil in your relationship today. You could be someone else's deliverer tomorrow. The chance is we need to aspire every time that there is an aspect of our pain. I don't know what pain it is people are going through right now in this COVID-19 business, but that pain can be turned into an aspiration, and we can change our lives with it. The second way that we aspire, that I've talked about, is when we have a vision of the best possible outcome. And probably we're not even having pain in our lives at this moment in time. But we can now look at life and we embody something greater, something higher that we can be able to aspire for, aspire towards. And now we start clothing ourselves to fit that particular bill. I give you an example of Zig Ziglar and Les Brown. Let's say that I aspire to become those guys. The time I wake up is not the same as the guy who doesn't have an aspiration. The things I read are not the same as the guy who does not have an aspiration. the things I expose myself to, my friends are not the same as those guys who do not have an aspiration. I am circumspect. I am totally different because I have an aspiration. Once again, let's go back to that scripture. God is able. There are actually six things that God can do. Number one, God is able. Number two, He's able to do. Number three, He's able to do exceedingly. Number four, He's able to do exceedingly abundantly. Number five, He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above. And number six, He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all. Number seven, that you can ask. Now that's where the difference comes in. Above all that I can ask or think or imagine. That is where the key is. He is able to do all those things, no doubt. But what am I imagining? What am I reaching out? What am I aspiring to? He is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all my imagination. In other words, when there is no imagination, when there is no aspiration, all these six things are basically useless. He can do all those things, but He is waiting for me. He is waiting for you to believe, to think, to aspire, to imagine. Without the imagination, you know, imaginations are life's next best attractions. So without us imagining those things and bringing them into focus and becoming incessant in pursuit of those things, then the aspect of God doing exceedingly abundantly above becomes impotent, so to speak. And therefore, you find that God is limited. There is actually something about being limited, God being limited by a human. Remember the story of Jesus Christ not able to perform a miracle in his home village because guys could not imagine that he could, and therefore he couldn't. I mean, there is even a scripture that he laments, "I have always wanted to hold you guys in my arms like a hen will have her chicks around her, but you will not let me." Our imaginations can limit our next best attractions in life. So whatever situation that and circumstances that we're going through right now, let us start imagining the best possible outcome. And I know it is not easy to do that imagination. That is why you and I must make attempts nearly every single day, attempts to imagine the best possible outcome for our lives in the areas that we are suffering and also in the areas that we are desiring to see change. If you're trying to think about it, to imagine about it today and it's not working, that's fine. Tomorrow can be better. Make sure that it's a consistent thing that you're doing so that you are the best, the guy with the best possible imagination of how life can turn out to be. At times, it is the only thing you can be able to do. There's some guys who do not have a lot of things to show for their lives, and they don't have a lot of capital, maybe a lot of networks. The only thing that can make you to start moving from point A to point B is your imagination. You can never get to your point B without the imagination, without the aspiration, without the vision of how that point B looks like. That's what I wanted to share with us today. And I hope it blesses you. I hope it makes sense to you. You can get much more of this information from my podcast, which is Life Signatures Radio. Go to Google and you can check it out, Life Signatures Radio. Or you can go to my blog, which is lifesignatures.life, and you can access much more out of that. In all you do, my friends, God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can think or imagine. The thinking and the imagining, they are the key that turns on the exceeding, the abundant, the impossible to become the possible. If we don't imagine, we can consider it a loss. And we can think that we are maintaining the status quo, but we're actually not maintaining the status quo. We are actually regressing. Well, until next time, when we'll be sharing something totally different that will be on my heart and on my spirit, I wish you all the best. Go out there and be the best possible version of yourself by imagining how it can turn out to be. Bye-bye, and God bless you. A special shout out to my mentor, Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University, found at mastermindmentor.com, who has graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.